iPhone 11 won't turn on humidity damage. Hello everyone, I'm Adriana and today with the help of Leonardo we are having in our workshop a new case of an iPhone affected by humidity. Specifically an iPhone 11 that has arrived from Barcelona. The repair of this device has a total cost of 158 euro. The objective of these classes is for you to learn how to carry out this type of repair and to be able to generate income. To thoroughly inspect the device, we need to remove the two screws from the bottom part and apply heat at 19 Celsius degrees with the hot air gun. In this way, the adhesive that bonds the screen to the device body softens. To remove the screen, we'll use an ultra thin pick, which we have polished on one side to make it even thinner, thus facilitating the detachment of the screen without causing damage. The first real step is to carry out a visual inspection looking for evidence of humidity in the device. In our case, we find a pink sticker that has popped up on the screen. This sticker, under normal conditions, should be white, but it changes to pink or red if the device has been in contact with liquids. Subsequently, we proceed to remove the screws and the metal sheet. Next, we remove the battery connector and the screen flex. It's crucial to disconnect the battery power before starting any repair to avoid the possibility of short circuit on the motherboard. To know the actual state of the device, we will connect it to a laboratory power supply. This will allow us to know if there is any short circuit or consumption on the motherboard. Apparently, the device turns on correctly, but we need to observe if it enters in power saving mode to be sure. What does power saving mode mean? When this mode is activated, your phone reduces or stops certain activities that usually consume a lot of energy, such as automatic updates of applications, screen lighting or processor speed. Depending on the settings, after 1-2 minutes, the device enters this mode. If consumption approaches zero, it means that the device is fine and there are no strange things in between. We can observe that consumption is gradually reducing, approaching zero. So far we've got good news, the consumption has dropped to 5 milliampere. Therefore, the problem with the device seems to be related to the screen circuits. As we suspected, the screen connectors show damage for corrosion, which caused a short circuit with the motherboard connectors. To facilitate the repair process, we are going to remove this protective foam. We observe corrosion between the connector's pins, so we use contact cleaner and a piece of cotton to clean the area. This chemical product not only cleans but also protects thanks to a special oil on its composition. Throughout the process, it's essential to apply common sense. In this way, we can save many devices. However, a good microscope is necessary. In the description of this video, I will leave you some links for the purchase of some recommended models, some economical and others more expensive. To repair the connector pins, we apply a little flux and solder paste. Subsequently, with the tip of the soldering iron at 350 Celsius degrees, we'll go over all the damaged pads. This step is crucial to repair these pads and ensure a correct connection. The last stage of this phase involves cleaning the work area with contact cleaner or isopropyl alcohol. These steps ensure that all impurities are removed and do not interfere with the device functionality. After completing all these steps, it's time to reassemble the screen and evaluate the device performance. Connecting the phone to our power laboratory supply, we notice a charge of 2.72 amperes, indicating good battery performance. However, upon further testing, we discover that the Face ID is not functioning. To solve this issue, I invite you to check out the link video above where I detailed the Face ID repair process. Given the complexity and the amount of work involved, the final price of €158 for the repair of this iPhone 11 is quite reasonable. If you are not going to give away your work, you have the opportunity to have the best tools and offer a quality service. Guys, this was today's video. He is Leonardo. We hope you find this tutorial helpful and we encourage you to try it by yourself. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.